Yo, what's up guys, welcome back from the Yu-Gi-Oh! Pro Duel video, next match, Cross Balanced Cup. Now, still at Group B, last match here. It should be pretty sure, well, if Zombisaur needs to win at least one to move on to the top 16 playoffs, right, while Baboon Burn is already out of the tournament, as we've seen in their past two matches. So, which deck has the advantage? Baboon Burn versus Minerva Sworn, you know, well, Light Sworn's... Well, not Minerva Sworn, but Zombie Sworn, you know, Light Sworn during Teladat. Baboon Burn dot deck, heavily focused on beasts, of course. Green Baboon pre-errata, by the way. The panda from, was it Dark Crisis, the set? I think so. Nostalgic deck, but quite of a strange deck, right? Well, on the other hand, Zombie Sworn. This should be Umut Siren's list again. I always forget it, Umut. Is it the Fortune Tour Finals? I think so, right? He always says that it's... his list here, like the zombie Teladat list, I guess. Or zombie variant, right, for Light Sworn is better compared to Teladat. I mean, his win streak back then definitely proved that. But, you know, that was a long time ago. Anyway, so going second, and that's a problem. Well, I mean, as I mentioned before, you know, the green Baboon dot deck, Baboon Burn, Baburn, is somewhat of a strange deck. It's running like those minus cards, like Just Desserts, Secret Barrel, while on the other hand, it's also somewhat focused on stalling, like Messenger of Peace, Level Limit Area B, Gravity Bind, you know, those cards. And Ariza is there, you know, it's quite of a strange list. Personally, I remember the deck very well from back then, 2007. It actually won, like, was it one of the bigger tournaments here in our country, like Belgium, the Netherlands back then. And again, it was strange because, you know, it was during the same time as, like, Destiny Hero Beatdown from your Disc Commander, Malicious, and so on. But anyway, so I'm rambling. But as you see, I mean, what can I do? Goyo Guardian is, of course, it's stronger than Baboon, first of all. And, you know, Green Baboon is this deck's MVP. Because pre-errata, you were, as a player of Green Baboon, Defender of the Forest, you were able to use Green Baboon during the damage step. So let's say if you suicide, or let's say your opponent attacks into your Nimble Momonga or Giant Threat, you were able to use or trigger a Green Baboon, let's say, from the graveyard, right, to drop it to the board. And back then, that was strong, Gorse-alike card, 2600, that's definitely very strong. The tokens definitely help out here, but, you know, I mean, let me think, is Light Sworns do have the capability to get rid of them? Of course, Synchro Summoning. Here with a Plague Spreader, for example, the Ojama tokens are all level 2, if I'm not mistaken. But there is, of course, also the opportunity to, or the chance to, let's say, put a token in deck position and, you know, to attack into, here in this case, Giant Red? Not sure. I mean, okay, you could leave them in defense, but I guess, and you know, that's what's going to happen. I guess it's just a matter of time that I'll be drawing into Panda, right? So, I guess you just should take the damage, or Jama 3, or at least one of the tokens, attacking, or well, now it's like, I guess, attacking into Green Baboon, so that's like 2006, 300 extra burn damage, yeah, that might be a lot. Okay, maybe you can expect like Just Desserts set, which is set, so that's already another 2500, but I guess it's something you could, or maybe should do, no? Well, I mean, like, look, what are the other options? There aren't any. Not sure if like there are any other options for Light Sworn or Zombie Sworn to get rid of a token, or at least 5 tokens on the field, other than, like, you know, suiciding with at least one of those and use the other ones for like a Synchro Summon. So use a third one. Only 400 life points left, but again, there is the opportunity to attack. Well, any burn damage, I guess, would have done it next turn, right? Attack over another token, yeah. A strange one. Maybe a bitter one, but I guess, you know, crashing with one of those tokens earlier on, like, maybe Giant Red, drop yourself to, like, 4k. It's maybe a danger zone, but what could you do, right? So again, number three, Psytech, and I do a Typhoon. The back row Typhoons are still in there because of Degree, right? Those were definitely there in Psytech, if I'm not mistaken. And Panda, I'm not sure about its base stat. Is it like 800? And for every monster your opponent controls, it will gain 500 attack points as well. The Compulse definitely comes in clutch. I believe those are Psytech. So getting rid of the Plague Spreader and here, yeah, the Panda definitely, its attack stat is much higher. It also has Trample damage, Trample effect, so it can attack over defense. That's perfect. Again, minimum manga triggering and cleaning the board, right? But I mean, against a deck like Zombie Sworn, it's not that, well, it's, what else could I have done, right? So Lumina into another one. That's dangerous against the deck that uses Ojama Trio. Then again, it's fine though, since okay, you'll be getting those mills during the end phase, and that's Lightsworn, old school, bunch of low level Lightsworns, right? Lumina, Garoth, Lila, those cards fill your graveyard, and then eventually go for game next turn, right? So it's not that devastating. Not wasting time, I guess. So Thoughtrul actually is a good choice also. And milling a wolf would be cool. You know, giving Panda another 500 attack boost. But the Colossal Fighter is a bit too big. Same for Thoughtrul or Archfiend. 2007, right? Plus, you know, I was about to say burn damage, no, but the life point boost, right? DD Crow definitely helps out preventing, again, the Plague Spreader from coming out. And I guess for another level 6 synchro play, so I need to top deck something, and it's going to happen. The Giant Threat, we've seen this before in the previous Cross Balance Cup match. Well, not sure if it was Giant Threat, but it was this guy, Neospatian Grand Mole. How powerful that, well, during that time, Grand Mole was actually limited, if I'm not mistaken, right? It was at 1 because it was so powerful against those extra deck cards, like, you know, Synchros. So Lumina milling 3, there is no Necro Gardener, I think. So yeah, I mean, what can I do? The Lightsworn deck is somewhat low on main deck cards as well. And Gorse is lurking in the background here. So that's very strong again. Lumina attacking in for 1,000 and Lila for 17. So that's fantastic. That's great. Because again, I don't think there's any other play left for Zombie Sworn. The potential Necro Gardeners are still there. Plague is not live. Not sure if there's Mizuki. If there's Mizuki, it probably... Oh, okay, there's one Necro Gardener. Okay, that's fine. Again, just going to bounce back the Lila. Again, not giving the deck, I guess, a level 4 on field for, you know, a potential Synchro Summon. Card of Safer Turn is strong. Oh, Mizuki, oh, it was probably milled. Yeah, late, at least last turn. Another Necro Gardener engraved, so it's not looking too great. But keep in mind, it's still Light Swords, and the deck count is on, like, 2. But you know, there is the gimmick of Plague Spreader, of stacking, you know, one card from your hand, I guess, to the top of your deck, so giving you at least an extra draw phase. But I draw Gravity Bind, so I'm like, okay, I'm still in this. Cyber Dragon should be attacking over one of the zombie monsters, right? And try to attack over the... Well, attack into Goyo and, you know, bounce it back. But Gravity Bind is going to, you know, stop basically every level 4. Yeah. Or higher monster in its tracks, so all of those monsters can't attack. Attack into Mirror Force, yeah, I mean, not putting the Cyber Dragon in defense didn't really matter too much, but one, you know, can't, I can't risk anything, right? Even though it's not going to matter too much, because again, Gravity Bind prevents all high attack, and plus Messenger, Messenger of Peace, and yeah, the last card in hand is indeed a card to save for you, and Embryonic wasn't available back then. Zubaboon is leading, but I'm honest, it's a little bit lucky on my part. So game number 4 goes second, and this hand is... it's okay, unless you're playing around the Ojama Trio, and that's what, you know, good play here, that's what what happens here, right, with double Lumina and one Lila. Plus, let's not forget that Lila in attack position is always, like Breaker, is like always threatening my back row, right? So an early Secret Barrel, that's not that great. It's always better, of course, with at least your opponent having like 5 monsters, preferably Ojama tokens, right? But you see, this is going to be a quick one. Stardust Dragon, I guess, just to be sure. And yeah, Dark... it's not Dark Roller. It's Revived King Hades is indeed going to prevent Sengen from triggering. So, yeah, nothing I can do about that. So a quick game number four. So game number five, I go first. And this is an okay hand set, Marshmallow Pass. Not using level limit. I mean, that's the thing. You could use level limits. Lila is immediately going to be switched to defense position. But as we've seen before, Dust Tornadoes are there. Heavy Storm, which, you know, is in the hand here. So I don't see any reason of using, a level limit. Because again, the potential aggressive route for this deck is still there. Cyber Dragon, Ryza. So, you know, I feel it's just better to keep the level limit here. The Necro Gardener hurt. Because, you know, if it wasn't for Necro Gardener, I would have been able to get rid of Lumina. And dropped the Grimmoon, right? And, you know, attack over Lila. But nope, Necro Gardener saves the day. While at the same time, the Clutch Snipe Hunter not rolling one or six. So popping one card at will. And that's a problem, and this, I guess, is going to be GG well played, because, the deck is able to use Card of Safe Return, Burial from a Different Dimension, getting out those three pluses, three special summons as well, three synchro summons, and Marshmallow is indeed eventually going to be destroyed by the Red Dragon, Archfiend, I believe the name is, and Nimble's effect is indeed going to be negated by Hades. It's not game, but I mean, my place for next turn, I guess Cyber Dragon and then Ryza, but what then? And yeah, just Dessert is not going to be enough. So Ryza hits the board, bouncing back Goyo, but you know, it's what is it going to do? End phase Royal Decree, and next turn, the bigger Synchro monsters are able to attack over it. So it's a small bummer, but again, as I mentioned before, I'm honest, the other two duels, or at least the two duels that Baboon Burn won, were kind of like steals. The zombie sworn deck is definitely better compared to Baboon Burn, but that's how it is, right? Also with the Psytex and a stall alike deck like Baboon can definitely have those sneaky wins with those stall cards, but that's how it is. So next matchup, we are moving to Group F, and we have Extra Deck Monarchs versus Eldritch Synchro. Important, you know, for these decks to potentially move on to the top 16 playoffs. Okay, guys, that's it. Thanks for watching. Feel free to leave a comment or like if you enjoyed the video. Liam signing out. Peace.